gentlemen, please welcome the Vice President of the Magic Castle, Pop Haydn!
What? That's enough, honey. We gotta get the show going. Good evening, folks. I hope you're enjoying your evening here at the Magic Castle. It's a wonderful place, is it not?
Yes.
Magic, as you may know, is the world's second oldest profession. Both professions are being ruined these days by amateurs. The case for one of which propositions I'm about to make. Now, ladies and gentlemen, over the years, magicians have gotten sort of a reputation for never explaining how anything is done. Until recently on Fox. I thought it would be fun if tonight, instead of trying to trick you and deceive you, if I actually taught you step by step how some of the classic feats of magic are performed. Would you like to learn how to do a magic trick?
Yes.
Good. First I'll do the trick and then I'll show you step by step how it was accomplished. We take a silk scarf, place it into the hand, and then you say the magic words. No. No. Show me the money's good. But for this one, it's Sim Salabim. Suddenly, the scarf is gone in its place as an A. The scarf has traveled all the way over here. It's actually kind of a stupid trick. No, seriously. See, the secret is the magician has two of these red scarves, one of which is hidden inside the egg. How else? See, you have two scarves, you have an egg, the contents of the egg have been removed. This is very important. Make a mistake here, you're going to mess up your scarves. You leave a hole inside the eggshell about the size of your thumb. You have one of the scarves hidden from the very beginning of the trick in a tight ball down inside your pocket. Since no one knows the scarf is down there, it gives you what we call in our profession the element of surprise. You wave the scarf around, stick it right inside the eggshell. Since no one knows you have an eggshell hidden inside your hand, that gives you a second element of surprise. Does everyone follow so far?
Yes. Oh, yeah.
You say the magic word, Sim Salabim. You drop the egg, you reach in your pocket, you get the scarf, you've done a magic trick. That's all there is to it. There is one problem with this trick. Occasionally there is some wise guy in the audience wants to see the egg. You cannot show him the egg, of course. That tends to give the secret of the trick away because everyone's going to see the hole. What you have to do is this secretly. Don't let anyone see you do this. Secretly. You peel that hole off of the egg. And hide it someplace inconspicuous. Now what that does, this will throw most people off. They want to look at it closer. You can let them look at it as closely as they want. Another trick that you may have seen a magician do at one time or another is where a piece of rope is cut and put back together again. I'm going to do the same thing, but once again, I'm going to show you step by step how it's done. Before we start, I'd like to have someone from the audience thoroughly examine this piece of rope. Make sure it is, in fact, what it appears to be, an ordinary, unprepared piece of rope. Would you, sir, go over every inch of that? Thank you so much. No, I'm kidding. Make sure there's no trap doors or mirrors, no hidden assistance. It doesn't stretch. It is a long piece of rope. Seemed like an ordinary piece of rope to you. Obviously it is. Otherwise, I wouldn't have let you look at it. Think about it. It's just a piece of rope, like you'd find in any bedroom. The secret of this trick is not in the rope. It's in a special knot the magicians have kept secret for hundreds of years, called the Mongolian pop knot. I'm going to teach you step by step how to tie this ancient and venerable knot. The first step is to measure the rope carefully. You want to make sure that when you cut, you get two pieces of rope exactly the same length. To put these back together again, you tie a Mongolian pop knot. Here's how it's tied. Take one rope, twist it around the other rope like this. Come back over this way. Come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You twist, come around, and pull tight, and that gives you one Mongolian pop knot. Is everybody with me so far? You reach into your pocket, you take some magic pixie dust. You sprinkle the pixie dust on the knot like this. In a few seconds, the pixie dust is going to cause that knot to dissolve and pop right off the rope, leaving you where you started from with one. Some of you may have had a hard time seeing exactly how to tie that knot, especially those of you in the cheaper seats. I'm going to do this again. This time we'll cut the rope into three even pieces. That gives you twice as much chance to see how the knot is tied, since it takes two Mongolian pop knots in order to put three pieces of rope back together again. Am I going too fast?
Yes.
Very seldom happens. Now remember, when you try this at home for your friends, make sure you cut all three pieces of rope exactly the same length. If you make a mistake here, the trick will not work. For example, if instead of cutting three ropes the same length, you were to make a mistake and one rope say a little short, the trick won't work. Get one rope about right, say, and the other rope too long, the trick will work. All three ropes have to be the same length. And this could happen to anybody. So if it happens to you when you try this at home for your friends, there is a way out. As long as I am teaching you the trick, I will teach you what we magicians call a contingency plan. Make a mistake cutting the ropes, you fold them over one at a time like this. Short, medium, and long. And you say the magic words, Sim, Salabim. You have to say these with a certain amount of conviction. Sim. Come on, this is the hard part of the trick, all right? Sim. Salabim. Suddenly the ropes begin to stretch and stretch and stretch like that, leaving you where you started from. All right, now back to the Mongolian pop knot. We take rope number one, rope number two. I'm going to tie these together. Watch closely. I'll go slow. You take one rope, twist it around the other rope like this. Come back over this way. Come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out. Then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You twist, come around and pull tight, you have one Mongolian pop knot. The second knot is tied the same way. You may want to take notes. You take one rope, twist it around the other rope like this, come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You know, I failed to see the humor. I don't think I'm alone in that either. Twist, come around, and pull tight. You have two Mongolian pop knots. Is everybody with me so far? Good. At this point, you simply reach in your pocket, you take some magic.
Pixie dust.
That's very good. That's very studious. You sprinkle the pixie dust on the knots like this. Any questions so far?
How long is the rope?
But how long is it? About 14 feet. Any other stupid questions? It's the only way we're going to learn. No other questions? Good. The pixie dust. Now that I grind my own. I want to have that fresh. That's important. I would send the kids out of the house. The pixies can make a hell of a noise. Can be distressing for the very young. A few seconds. The pixie dust. I know. Causing us to dissolve and pop right off the rope, leaving you where you started from with one. You guys are a great audience. I wish I had a better act. But I have discovered over the years that people will miss some step in a trick, even when it's being explained from this great a distance. Sometimes it's helpful to have a little personal instruction. What I'd like to do is find some spectator from the audience who would like to learn the world's oldest magic trick. You're not doing a damn thing at the moment, are you, honey? Would you come up and take her a drink? Bring her up here. Let's give her a big hand. Bring her up. Excellent. Well, what's your name?
Porva.
Porva.
Got it.
What, Porva? Is that? That's a beautiful name.
Thank you.
Where is that from?
From India.
India. Oh, that's so great. Porva. Namaste.
Namaste.
Okay, so hi.
What?
I'm not as dumb as I look. Porva, I'm going to teach you how to do the world's oldest magic trick.
Okay.
You have to pay close attention, okay? Shut up. Over 2,000 years old, the ancient miracle of the Chinese linking rings. It's a classic. Like Great Expectations. You have to learn it. Porva, this is ring number one. This is ring number two. This is ring number three. And this is ring number four. Four separate solid bands of steel. You ready so far?
I'm great.
Good. Which one is this?
One.
Exactly right. Can you guess this ring too?
Two.
This is going to be easier than you thought. What I want you to do is pick a spot on your ring, any spot at all that looks like a solid spot to you. Hold your ring like this so the solid spot will be right up here. Does that look like a solid spot to you right there? Did you notice any holes in your ring anywhere?
No, no holes. No.
You missed one, honey. That joke is over 2,000 years. But it's important. See, without this hole, the trick will not work. No, see, without this hole, it wouldn't even be the ancient miracle of the Chinese link and ring. Would it? It'll be the ancient miracle of the Chinese Lincoln hubcaps. See, the idea is to take this hole and put it into that hole. Which seems kind of odd when you think about it. In order for that to happen, solid steel has to pass through solid steel. The miracle of penetration. Don't blink, this may be the best shot you ever get at this ancient miracle. Solid steel. Do solid steel, ready? Or go, one! I'll be a little more gentle. Two! Solid steel ring linked to another solid steel ring. That's the first part of the trick. The second part of the trick is to take the rings apart. You hold them just like this. You give the rings a spin this way in kind of a circular motion. And then you blow right in the center like this. Wow. It's your turn. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time on any stage presenting Porba, the Magnificent, in a feat of prestidigitation and leisure domain over 2,000 years old, the ancient miracle of the Chinese linking rings. That's it. This is ring number one. This is ring number two. I want you to hold your rings up just like this. That's perfect. This is ring number three. This is ring number four. I'm going to hold mine up the same way. On the count of three, I want you to drop one ring. When I count to three, drop one ring like that so it links into the other ring. Hold one ring tight, let the other ring just drop. Got the idea? How I should put it.
Yeah.
One, two, three.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Magical genius. Most people don't get this far in this trick. Now watch this. Here's the important part. Do this. Perfect. That's good. That's great. That's great. See, that doesn't really do anything. That's how you get the applause. You go like this. It's show business.
Right.
Like parsley on fish. Now, here's the important part. You hold your rings like this. Give them a spin this way in kind of a circular motion. That's, yeah, use a little more wrist action, more of that kind of stuff. That's good. Once you get it going, you're going to blow right here in the center. So you take your rings like this, you give them a spin like this, you blow right in the center. Ready? One, two, three, blow. They go right through each other. Put one ring up your arm, put the other ring down in your hand. Take the ring on your shoulder and give it a push so it slides all the way down your arm, back inside this ring like so. And give it a spin like that. Well, you're doing great. Most people don't get this far.
You're a magical genius. Thank you.
You're like certifiable. Now here comes the second method for taking the rings apart. You're doing great.
Thanks.
Hold your rings like this. Give this ring a spin like so. Put that ring up, spin the other ring the same way. Take your left hand, reach the hole like this. Grab this ring down here. Pull it straight out to the hole like that. Put it back through the hole the same way. So you end up with two rings linked back together again. Like so. This brings us to the third, the final, the most difficult, and the most dangerous method ever devised for taking two solid metal rings apart. Are you ready for this? Hold your rings like this, like a bow and arrow. Let's point more toward them, though. What you're going to do for them, you're going to take the ring in your right hand, give it a spin like this, so it passes right through here. Its momentum will carry it back, put up your head loose at a speed of about 20 miles an hour. In order to avoid serious bodily damage, you have to take your right hand, thrust it through the ring as it comes around. If you miss, you're going to get bonked right on the noggin. You understand so far? Here we go. Hold your rings like this. Ready? Get set. One!
Oh, sorry. Minus it. I should
have said get set. I know. I'm sorry. It's a stupid way to make a living. On the count of three, honey. Ready? One, two, three. Like that, it comes right off. Take that same ring. Throw it straight up in the air like this. Catch it in midair just like that, so you have two rings. Look at you. Rings linked together in a chain. If I take one of these rings, pull it straight up like this, we end up with four rings interlocked so that every ring is linked twice through two other rings. Twice through two other rings. Thank you. When we blow on these, they melt right through each other into one long chain. When you collapse the chain, you end up with three rings on one ring. Which is impossible. Let's count these off. This is ring number
four.
Ring number four. This is ring number three. This is ring number two. And this.
Say the magic word.
What?
You just say the magic word.
What magic words? I think we blow. I think you just blow. Yeah, that's it. That's it. For the last trick that I'm going to teach you guys this evening, I'm going to take the liberty of removing my jacket. And rolling up my sleeves. It's just that a lot of times people think that we magicians might stoop to some cheap trick, such as hiding things in special pockets in our jackets or up our sleeves. After the open and honest relationship we've enjoyed thus far this evening, I would hate for you to think such a tawdry thought of me. I brought with me a copy of the USA Today. As you can see, there is nothing in it I'd like you to remember some picture or advertisement from the paper so you'll recognize it when you see it again. What I intend to do is to rip this paper into shreds and put it back together again. Now, you know as well as I do that's impossible. There's no way anyone could actually tear something up and put it back together again. It has to be a trick. It is. No, it is. The secret is that the magician never really tears the paper up. He only pretends to tear the paper. He creates what we magicians call an illusion. If you watch closely, you'll see that the paper is never actually torn. Now, most magicians will not tell you this. They let you think they're really tearing the sucker up. You can laugh, but if you didn't know, you would fall for this. No, seriously, I have people come back after a show and say, you know, Pop, that's my name, Pop. They say, you know, Pop, even though I knew you weren't really tearing the paper up, it looked so real. I can almost imagine that I saw separate pieces of paper. Which is, of course, impossible. Now, at this point, most magicians will give you some kind of balderdash about how they're going to magically fuse weld all the edges of the paper back together again with some kind of mystical, magical fuse welding process. I don't have to do that, since you know as well as I do, this paper was never actually torn. A paper which has never been torn.